Kiki Smith is going to be known for a distinctly unflattering approach to the representation of the human body. And she's going to be the daughter of a minimalist sculptor. In her work, she explores the question of who controls the human body. And because of her experience as an EMT, her studies of bodies afflicted by illness have affinities with other artists' works, addressing the physical devastation brought on by various illnesses. Now, she has an interesting view. She's trying to show us a lot of ideas that we wouldn't get in quote-unquote polite society. Many of her pieces will bring up ideas similar to, for example, Frida Kahlo's Broken Column, where she's showing us invisible illness. So what Kiki Smith is trying to do is show us the human form in a very imperfect, well, form. And we're going to be looking at Untitled by Kiki Smith. Now, in this case, the artist dramatically departs from convention, both in art and the media. She's suspending two life-size wax figures, one male, one female, both nude from metal stands. Smith marked each of the sculptures with long white drips. The male figure, the drips are coming from the breast, the male figure, the drips are coming from the penis down the thigh. The female figure, the drips are coming down from the breast. And there's actually a reason for this. She saw it as these functions of the body that are hidden from society. To her, quote, "We separate our bodies from our lives. But when people are dying, they're losing control of their bodies, and that loss of function can seem humiliating and frightening. But on the other hand, you can look at it as a kind of liberation of the body. It seemed like a nice mixed metaphor. A way to think about the social, that people lose control despite the many agendas of different ideologies in society, which are trying to control their bodies. These groups include medicine, religion, law. Just thinking about control, who has control of the body? Does the mind have control of the body? Does the society have control of the body? So it's all about the body, the hidden aspects of the body. And interestingly, when she depicts the body, she's doing so in a very postmodern way. There's no depicting the perfect form as we see with the spear bearer, for example, from ancient Greece. Instead of idealizing the form, trying to fit it to this perfect rendering that is supposed to be acceptable to all of society, Kiki Smith has given us more of a specific reality, and she's pushed that reality. She's pushed it by including details such as pubic hair, by making the figures very generic, very basic, by including those long white waxy drips. She's doing this intentionally to call our attention to what the media says is a perfect form by showing us our form. Many of us would fit one of these two body forms, maybe somewhere in between, maybe not. That's possible as well. But underscoring the diversity of contemporary art, not all figure painters have worked in this realistic mode. We have people, of course, working with various levels of abstraction. And here the abstraction comes not in the form itself, but rather in the idea behind it. It is conceptual art because there is a discussion that would take place going along the lines of, is it art? What are the white marks? Why is it here? Why are these figures looking depressed? Why are they looking the way that they are? Why are they on metal stands? Any of these ideas can happen. They're postmodern because they go beyond larger rules in society. There is no idealization here. These are not the proper forms. The female figure is not covering her genitalia, which she should be according to artistic tradition. So there's a lot taking place here. It's arguably possibly some form of activist art about media portrayals of the human form and showing us what the human form really looks like. It could be argued that the nudity is key and that this is all about revealing ourselves to the world. it's kind of tricky to deal with. And that's the key to Kiki Smith, but also to postmodernism. Your interpretation is going to be subjective. It's going to be individual. And according to postmodernism, it's going to be correct.